elects his men and to vote for parliamentary elections. Look at how far we've come from being considered only for domestic and child rear duties, having three women prime ministers in office running the country. This exhibition honours courage and aspects we don't accomplish to raise awareness of issues in women and to highlight the path towards equality. Each has a story to tell, and those stories contribute to the dialogue around the movement. So I'd just like to pick out a couple of works that I'd just like to make a special mention to. This one is Spice's work. That's a portrait of Neri Titai Manukahia, who in 1848 woman to address Parliament when she made a request that would have been any diligence in the Maori Parliament, thus going a step further than the contemporary aims of the European suffrage movement. This is Christine Cookwork, Deeds Not Words, on the wall. So Deeds Not Words, this is adopted by the suffragettes of the world, of the Women's Social Union in the UK and Nairobi. So that's Deeds Not Words. So Into the Sunshine is a piece called Into the Sunshine. Are We There Yet? A participatory project by Angela Rowe. Angela invites us to add a signature, a unique mark or response to the question, are we there yet? Two pieces of a garment that she will sew over the course of a day on Saturday the 29th of September. The finished garment will become a tangible historical documentation of this event, a collection of autographs or marks representing the thoughts of the participants. Come along on Saturday the 29th of September between 10 and 4 to contribute. So I'd now like to introduce Caroline Ursich. From our sponsor Rudolph's, to announce the recipients of her sponsored awards.
I'd like to welcome everyone here today. It is a hugely significant day. Firstly, I'd like to tell you that I have never been a judge of an award or exhibition before, so this is a brand new experience process for me. But I have been part of the female movement. In my early 20s, I was part of the Wellington Home Birth Association. We did a petition to Aunt King to get autonomy for midwives. So that bill, after a few years of work, did action for us. So the message behind that is that there's always hope. It's about taking an idea and a thought, believing in it, and seeing it through. I've also been involved a lot in male-dominated industries. I have 13 years in the concrete industry, and for the last 18 years I've been involved in the blasting industry. So it's a little bit about building up and stripping things down. From a judging point of view, I thought this would be a breeze. I know what I like. I know when I go to an exhibition, one or two things really jump out at me. I think this, so when I was asked, I was, yeah, I'll do that. So, based on that philosophy, is partly where the judging has gone today. But firstly, I really do acknowledge every individual who contributed an artwork to this exhibition. And I think in honour of that, and to acknowledge everyone, because every piece of work has got something special. I'd like to present this white camellia to Sally, and for it to be planted here in the quarry, so that as you sort of come and visit the quarry years to come, you might remember this day and your contribution, you know, to this event. So on behalf of Rudox, this is a white female in honour of the suffrage and woman of today. So we started off by thinking we'll just, you know, a prize, but as I said, that process wasn't as easy and as simple as what we had hoped it, what I had hoped it to be. It did cause me some challenges. I sort of went home, challenge some of my thinking processes around that. So to start off with, I think because of New Zealand's very special, I think what happened in New Zealand 125 years ago is very special. There's a few more than just one award. So the first acknowledgement I'd like to make, I've called it the Caroline's Camellia Award, and it's just a small token of acknowledgement. I have a passion for flowers and a passion for camellias, so this is just an acknowledgement to Ellie Goodman for her work. So the word animus comes to mind. and so that's congratulations to Thea Price. But unfortunately, so Sally will take that on your part.
Inspiring. Yeah. So just enjoy.